going on, people? It's KC from www.kc-sounds.com. Today's video is a beat making video, and I've got ideas in my head that I want to get down. I had two ideas in my head, and then what happened was started getting some sounds together, picked up the Rhodes, and then started playing some chords, and I like how the chord sounds, so I'm going to go with the chords for this beat. As you can see, I'm wearing the new KC Sounds t-shirts. I don't know if you can see for the microphone in the way, but yeah, KC Sounds logo t-shirts now available on my website. So if you wanted to purchase and get involved with that, then hit the link in the description box and yeah, buy one. Appreciate all of that. So yeah, let's just get into this beat making video. See if I can get these ideas down quickly before I forget them. I'm gonna go for 130 BPM on this one here. Whoops, this guy again. I think the BPM's too fast. Let me go with 115. See how that rolls. All right, let's go with that. I think that first note of the bass, yeah, it's in. something's not right there. No, don't like that. Scrap that. All right, let's go ahead. Got some hi-hats in there just to give it some groove, and then I'm going to join that because it's two different parts that I played in, because it's captured what I was just playing without pressing record. Then it's just to join them two as one file, you press J. That's nice. Thank you. Shift and R, and then J to join them all up. So it's all on that one MIDI pattern there. So if you want to go in and tweak stuff, you can. And it's on 8th notes. It should be 16 because I had some extra hi-hats in there that wasn't showing, but they are now. I want to give it some of that trap hi-hat rolls there. Then percussion sounds a bit loud, so I'm just going to take the velocity down. I could go into the ultra beat and do it with the volume, but I'm going to do it with the velocity for now. And then open hi-hats, I'm going to keep running through all the way. I think that's right. No, it ain't. Yeah, it is. I'm gonna have that running right through the beat, right through that drum pattern. And there I want some more of them hi-hat runs just going off there. Piece. And what's going on there? What I'm going to do is have that twice. Might be annoying. Second time, but we'll try it, see if it works. Keep it. Then I'm gonna go for, let's try that. No, don't need that because it's clashing with the Rhodes already, unless I go into the Rhodes and do a bit of EQing and stuff so it fits in, but I can't bother to do that, so I'm gonna try a different sound instead. Do we're gonna make that 16th notes because it certain notes aren't playing. Missed the first note. Someone asked me a question before about how I come up with melodies, so I'm gonna do a video on how I come up with the melodies. But just to let you know for now, what I do is if I'm playing like the first chord on this, I think was A minor. So if you know theory, I don't really know theory all that well, but I know that the A minor is all white notes, so any white notes is going to work for the melody. But I'm gonna do a video on that soon, very soon, if I haven't done one already by the time you're watching this video. Let's see what this is saying. Last note didn't play. I'm gonna go with that one for now. I think it caught it. Yeah, let's just go with that. Got, as you can see, I've got four different parts there played in, so I can choose which one I want to use. I can duplicate that if I decide to flatten the first one. So I can, when I'm structuring it, I can go on to the next variation that I played, so it gives it a bit interest because it keeps changing and stuff, so it doesn't get boring. Whatever sound do I want? I like to pack them out with sounds at first. If you've been watching my videos, you'll notice this, and the reason I do that is because it's just building. So once I have all my sounds and stuff, I can take certain bits out and then structure it to make it a full song or a full beat. So let's see what we got here. What's going on with that sound though? I'm gonna take it out for now. Took the wrong sound out. Oops. So I only need that one note, and I'm gonna play every two bars, is it? Something like that. I like the bell sound, but it sounds a bit off for me, so I'm not gonna bother with it. Let's see what this thing here is. Is a bit loud, and I think this one is another one. I don't like that note all the way up there, and it's loud as well. Nah, I don't need that there, to be honest. It's clashing again with the road, so I'm just going to jump in and put some 808s on there and see if I can add another melody. If not, I'm just going to leave it at that. put that in there for now and put it on the 16th notes because there's a little run in there somewhere. A couple of notes misplaced, or a couple of notes that I played weren't right, but I can change that. Yes, there's a couple of things in there I'm going to change, but I just wanted to get the idea down quickly and then just carry on from there, just build it and keep building and build it to it's a finished song. I appreciate your time. Thank you for watching. I hope you got something from this video. If you want to keep up to date with stuff that I'm doing, hit the subscribe button. If you like this video, hit the like button. I appreciate all of that. And yeah, thank you for your time. Thank you for watching. Music is life. Peace.